started, but then in the last 20 years, it has actually been calculated, it is now 1 in 1,000 women are getting bald. See, even that kind of changes we are able to bring in the human existence because of unmindful, unscientific way of just drinking water. So, what do we do? Forget about food. We have screwed up the baby's food, not only baby's food, milk. Most problematic thing is that in foreign countries, the toilet training is a big problem. They started having wrappers of this plastic diapers. The baby, almost 10 hours, 20 hours in a day, is with the diapers. So the plastic content not only is going through mouth, going through the back and rear ends, started playing havoc with the health of the babies. Not at all bothered. No one cares, because it is the plastic companies that are deciding what is good for you and what is not good for you. And can you believe that now Bangalore has a problem of these diapers on the roads, and you find them in the stomachs of many of the animals. No one cares. No one really cares. What do we do? What are we doing? These milk companies keep injecting hormones to produce more milk. Each and every cow has to give 10 to 20 liters because they are interested in doing business. And they don't care what they are producing. On top of it, the doctors come and keep bombarding each and everyone, saying that milk, complete food, you have to give your kids. For heaven's sake, the milk digesting enzyme gets switched off at the age of 4 in human beings. That means no human being needs to drink any milk at all. It is mother's milk that we should be drinking, not some other animal's milk. Cow gives 1 or 1.5 liters milk to satisfy the needs of its baby. And if something is left, human race in the olden days used to ferment it into curds with the lactobacillus. And then, especially, used to have buttermilk and then butter and then ghee, whatever was left. But now, Bangalore alone, and 10 lakh liters of milk on a daily basis. Where is it coming from? It's all unnatural. It is laced with oxytocin, estrogen, and some more chemicals. So the babies are fed this milk on a daily basis from second month or third month, because mothers are discouraged not to give milk to their kids because this milk is in large quantities. Can you believe this nonsense? But this is what is happening. That actually indirectly produces troubles for the lactating mothers, because they are stopping their milk production unnaturally for some various reasons. And they get breast lumps, some getting converted into cancerous, called malignant tumors. All these things are happening right under our nose. No one cares and no one talks about it. So many women getting breast lumps, which are 50 to 70% these doctors declare as malignant and start removing the breast. Then these tumors appear elsewhere and then they transform it into cancerous conditions. Then you have chemotherapy, you have radiotherapy, you have this therapy, that therapy, and then ultimately it metastasizes into various other organs. This whole thing is now converted into billion to trillion dollar business. A simple thing like feeding babies naturally has been stopped. For what reason? Because these guys are producing enormous amount of milk. Can you see this vicious circle of business entering into our natural, beautiful way of giving food to the mother giving his milk comes along with colostrum, a antibody produced in the mother's milk, filling the baby's body to see that the babies have immunity for certain period of time till they produce the antibodies in there. For that, some time is required because the bones have to develop to produce the immunity within the body. So till then, mother's milk is loaded with this kind of wonderful mechanisms. But then, in the name of science, in the name of producing more milk, the so-called biotechnology, and everyone is made to believe that milk is very good for us, and the whole world started drinking milk. Not only the babies, the elder people also said, till you die you can drink. The milk you drink, in fact, hundreds and thousands and lakhs of kids are suffering because of this unnatural milk being taken into the bodies. They suffer immunity problems, that is coughing, sneezing, ear pain, so many problems. So in the last 15 years after I came back, I have been encouraging all kids, mothers and fathers to stop the milk. I couldn't believe the effect of stopping the milk. Many kids suffering from various ailments become all at a sudden within 6 weeks completely all right the moment they stop drinking this unnatural milk. Completely, absolutely no problems. The mothers start saying that they have started sleeping in the night. Not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, thousands of families. In fact, in the last 15 years, I have started giving lectures. Wherever I go, I talk about this. And the moment mothers stop giving this plastic milk, I call this plastic milk because everything is transported in plastic. In fact, in the early stages, they were transporting in milk bottles. All of a sudden, it became inconvenient. They switched to plastic. So now, 15, 20 years, the whole world is running on plastic containers. Everything is transported in plastic. Only thing that cannot be transported in plastic is fluoric acid. And that everything is now transported in plastic. Such horrible effects it has, because these plastic nanoparticles are absorbed, not chemically, they just absorb. In fact, so sad that nowadays Ayurveda industry is also transporting their churnas, basmas, all this, including honey, is transported in plastic bottles. So the medicinal effect of the medicine is absolutely out of the window, and we are actually getting the sickness being transported into your tummies, even through the medicines. This is the sad story of business entering into the world of food and medicine. And no one has any objections, because all these authorities are being completely bought by the corporate offices. So no one cares, no one questions. Water, milk. Then comes the most dangerous thing that has happened in the last 40, 50 years is the diesel industry, that is oil, higher octane, that is beyond carbon 8. You have it as diesel and petrol, and the lower carbon units like hexane, butane, pentane, it's an oil called mineral oil, very transparent, very clean, but not be used as petrol or diesel, because it cannot burn and give enough energy, so it's not efficient to burn. So they produce almost 30 to 40% liter to liter. So if they produce 10 liters, 3 liters of this mineral oil is produced on a daily basis in this oil rigging stations. So all over the world, because of diesel and petrol consumption increasing exponentially, they also started getting this mineral oil left over. So they had to find some use for this. So it's a waste, but they don't want to throw it. So they started making into various chemicals. And that's how all these chemicals started appearing in our world. So it is the waste management of this corporate culture that has created all these problems. Can you believe this? It came so suddenly in the decades of 70s and 80s, and then it has transformed all our life into sick. Because that has found itself, this waste has found itself in various forms, to the extent that it has displaced all the oil that is used in the world which were natural, be it groundnut, be it olive, be it coconut, be it sesame seed oil, be it mustard oil. So many various oil products were found in various parts of this world, our planet. So different people, different geographical conditions, different varieties of oil seeds were produced, and small amounts of oil extracted using local techniques. And all this oil was wonderful for the growing babies, because we needed the fat content of the plant-based, plant origin. Those were the building materials of our internal organs, made of completely fat, including the brain, the liver, the pancreas. Lot of it is made of fat material. So this fat material, when we were growing up, the kids needed these wonderful natural oils. Then all at a sudden we find this being displaced by these mineral oils and the chemicals. Whatever oil you want, they add that color and the consistency and the flavor is produced synthetically in the labs and started being added to this mineral oil. This mineral oil is not only the basis of many other chemicals, but also is displacing our natural oils. And then we all at a sudden found millions of liters of this oil sold in different forms. Be it coconut oil, be it all olive oil, any oil you want, we will produce, give the color, the consistency and the flavor. So in the name of oil, all of us in the world are now consuming this mineral oils. And you know one thing, these mineral oils are making our intestines hydrophobic. Our intestine, small intestine, should be always hydrophilic. That means where absorption takes place, it is all through water. And these mineral oils are not hydrophilic, whereas the natural oils are hydrophilic. This is the basic difference. So, see our wonderful scientists and corporates have done. So the most important part of our growing up now has been screwed up. Forget about the food. To be healthy, we should be eating all ingredients nicely stuffed by God in various forms, food materials. Instead, now what have we become? We are drinking plastic, water, we are taking plastic oils, we are drinking plastic milk. I have not come to the food as such. You will start seeing the effects of this so profoundly that young boys and girls do not have hair. And young boys and girls started having hormone imbalance even before they grow up. In fact, it was very sad for me to receive a call from America. A young boy, 8 years old, started having pubic hair and started behaving very, very differently, because his whole system is screwed up because of this hormone imbalance. And many of the women find it very, very difficult to manage this hormone imbalance. In fact, it is very bad on my part to say this, but I have no other choice other than saying this. The beauty parlors, number of beauty parlors, suddenly you find increasing in each and every country. The reason is very simple, that the hair on your chins and mustaches appearing has started increasing because of the hormone imbalance. This is a direct proof for all of us that what we are doing is completely unnatural, that no one wants to notice it. No one wants to notice it. These are all the peripheral things that have started disturbing the human health. And no one is interested in talking about this or doing anything about this. And slowly and steadily you start entering the domain of food. You will see what kind of advertisements that are going on. Now here in one side, Shah Rukh Khan comes and asks us to drink Coke. Another side, Amir Khan comes and asks Pepsi. I think it's other way around or something. And then says thumbs up. And then this is foreign drink, this is Indian drink, another confusion. But all these guys are selling not Pepsi, not Coke, not thumbs up, not this, not that. They are all selling nothing but sugar in a 100 ml water, 40 to 45 grams. So now comes the main problem of sugar. It is the sugar that is the most addictive thing on this planet for human race. How much are we producing? Name of producing sugar, the human race actually is producing liquor. So to produce liquor, we civilized human societies call it as sugar industry. What is the role of sugar in our digestion? This is where the most horrible thing has happened. Because they started producing sugar as byproduct for liquor industry, they started pushing sugar in each and every to the extent that no scientist, no biochemist, no nutritionist, no doctor, no one till today has said sugar is the main problem of human race. Sugar is the main problem of the human race. I want all of you to understand, this is the most disturbing thought that everyone should entertain on a daily basis, because we have been brainwashed by all this. Because growing sugar, preparing sugar on this planet Earth, has been the essence of corporate, because to produce 1 kilo sugar, you need to provide 28,000 liters of water to produce 1 kilo of sugar. 28,000 liters of water. How much? 28,000 liters of water. So to produce 28,000 liters of water, you need to build a dam. See the connection. So, humongous amount of work goes on to build these big, big dams in the world. Because slowly and steadily, human beings start doing agriculture based on water. So, they also slowly found if we can give water, we can produce more amount of rice or wheat, because when you have waterlogged system based agriculture, you can then slowly dump the fertilizers. Once you give fertilizers, instead of producing 5 quintal to 8 quintal on a dry land, I can produce in 1 acre 20 to 35 quintals of food. So, this became